This is our Deadpool review, so we're about to give you our verdict, because we've just seen it.
We did, and this is going to be a spoiler-free review, because, yes. I mean, it's we just don't come really out. Wanna, and
yeah. Also, if you would like to hear the spoiler version of our review, you can listen to the podcast.
Which will be out on Friday.
Yes,
it'll where be we will the speak freely.
Yes.
So, Sam, what did you think of the movie?
I really enjoyed it. One sort of issue I had with it was... Obviously, my expectations for this film were so high that there was no way that the film would ever sort of meet those expectations.
Definitely. It was one of those things that I'd been waiting for a long time. Like, I was around when the first test footage was leaked, and I've been excited for it ever since then. And when it came out, it was sort of... It was a little bit underwhelming in a way, because just in your head, you expect so much. And
yeah.
They can't possibly do that.
There was no way they would ever meet those expectations.
Yeah, definitely. And it was... By far the best comedy movie I've seen in a hell of a long time.
Yeah, I mean, the jokes were hilarious, but I feel like there was a big handful of the jokes from the film were spoiled in the trailer.
Yeah, that was kind of an issue because, I mean, in the trailer, they felt like they were being delivered for a trailer purpose.
Yeah.
And I thought they might, like, change them or rearrange them or make them a little bit more crude.
Mm.
But they didn't really do that. They just sort of used the footage from the
Yeah, I think a lot of us were sort of expecting film. that they would have maybe filmed 10 versions of a scene and they would use one that we hadn't seen in the trailers or something. Like the funnier joke. But that was not the case, unfortunately. So if you have seen the trailers, a lot of the jokes will be the same in the film.
Mm-hmm. Just with a bit more context.
Yeah, with a bit more context.
One of the things that we both discussed, I think, was some of the jokes fell quite flat in some ways.
Yeah, in our theatre, there wasn't... A lot of the jokes, or a lot of the things that were said that felt like they should be jokes, mm-hmm. got no response.
Yeah.
And, like, we didn't laugh at some of them.
Yeah, but I think a lot of them, like, we sort of got, but didn't really understand the context of them enough due to where we're from, maybe.
And I think that's something to do with the whole, we're from the UK, as you can probably tell, and obviously the film is American, so there was probably this kind of nation barrier in some of the jokes that they would have got that we didn't.
But saying that, there was a few instances where... It felt very aimed at the UK and at British comedy and humour, just with references to the guy who plays Ajax being English.
Mm.
So there was a few sort of...
Nods to that kind of...
A few banterous things said about that.
Which we can find a bit more funny,
And I think another thing they did really well with, like, trying to aim at British stuff was, like, that was really creative, and they used that sort of thing to be really creative with how to get around, like, the budget issues they had, maybe.
Yeah.
And, like... one thing they were really creative with was trying to get around the sort of male nudity, which there's a whole scene where Ryan Reynolds is fully naked for it.
Yeah.
And they sort of, there's a few creative ways of them filming him naked without showing dong. Although they do. They do show Ryan Reynolds'
film
dong.
Definitely doesn't hold back in that kind of area. There's a lot of nudity. There's a lot of violence. A lot more violence than I was expecting.
Yeah.
And I think that a lot of people maybe were expecting...
Yeah,
which probably stays true to the comics.
Yeah, it was very gory, and it felt like it's pretty much, I think, the perfect transition from comics to screen.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, we see X-Men in proper sort of X-Men costume for the first time ever until, like, maybe X-Men Apocalypse later this year.
Yeah, it's really, like, the gore isn't disgusting. It's kind of like... It's joke gore.
Yeah, it adds.
That makes sense.
Yeah, it's excessive and it adds to the
comedy of the film. Yeah,
it's gore in a way as some of the comic relief, like in some sections. Like,
As much as there is jokey violence, the film really does kind of have a heart, which is something I wasn't expecting. But I'm glad that there is.
Yeah, it's very contrasting to see sort of Wade Wilson compared to Deadpool. Like, they are very different characters. Like, the Merc with the Mouth isn't the guy who gets diagnosed with cancer. That's, those scenes are very, very, like, human in many ways. Like, they joke about cancer in a way, like, well, that's a bit shitty.
It's in a very nice way.
In a very sort of human way. Like, laughter is a form of medicine type way.
It's very careful about the way they approach it. It's never, like, horrible. I was really concerned that I could feel the kind of, like, everyone in the audience suddenly react badly to it.
Oh, shouldn't have said that.
Yeah, and there was definitely never a moment
in this film where
it didn't feel insensitive to the subject of cancer. Yeah. It's handled very well.
And it really supports the idea that Ryan Reynolds is the perfect casting choice for this film, because he pulls off the milk with the mouth, but he also pulls off the very like
heartful
heartful bits,
emotional. Really, like, there are scenes where he doesn't say much,
yeah,
but you can really feel it.
It's genuinely touching, just due to how he reacts and stuff. Although saying that, there are also some moments of great comedy. Like, this is by far the best Stanley cameo I've ever seen in any Marvel movie, I think.
Just because it's so outrageously brilliant.
Like, now I've seen it, it's the only way they could have done a Stanley cameo in this film. Like, we weren't sure there were going to be any cameos at all in this this movie, and Stanley's is great.
He shows up and he nails it.
Another thing we weren't sure about was the after credits sequences. We weren't sure if there were going to be any.
Yeah, there was kind of a part of us that thought, there's got to be, right?
Yeah.
There's got to be a parody of it. And the way they did it was perfect. They handled it perfectly.
It was done so well. And
so what do you think about the future of Deadpool then?
I like the way it ended, because it leaves it open.
I hope other studios see this and think, we can do this as well.
And it would be good to see them have a bigger budget next time and continue further with a bigger budget.
Definitely.
So Sam, would you recommend it?
I would absolutely recommend it, especially if you're on the fence and you haven't seen any of the trailers or anything. Mm-hmm. Go see this film, because all the jokes will land. It is hilarious and brilliant. Neil, what is your verdict?
I would 100% recommend it. Even if you have seen the trailers, I think the jokes that you haven't seen the trailers, you're going to love. And even the ones you have seen in the trailers, in context, they're still funny and they're still delivered in such a good way.
Go see this film.
Do it.
Thank you very much for listening.
Cheers. Bye-bye. Cheers.